Hello, teacher friend. Today's video is going to be a short but very useful one. I am going to show you how you can integrate Canva slides into your Nearpod presentation. Nearpod and Canva are two of the top tools I use in the online classroom. If you want to learn about the third tool that I enjoy using in the classroom, you can check out my YouTube video, Top Tools to Use in the Online Classroom, Increase Online Student Engagement with These Three Tools. So I love Nearpod because it gives me the ability to add games and interactive features within my lessons. My students are able to complete activities directly on their computer or tablet, and I can see their results in real time. It's really pretty amazing. I also love Canva because it allows me to design professionally looking presentations, resources, games, and activity sheets that attract and maintain my learners' focus during the lessons because they're actually interested in what's happening on the screen. So while you can use these two tools separately and these two platforms separately, the magic really happens when you combine them, which is what I'm going to show you how to do today. So trust me, it's a game changer. And of course, if you find this video helpful, please give it a like and a subscribe and turn on notifications so you can get a heads up when new videos go up. So I'm going to go ahead and share my screen with you so we can take a closer look on how to combine Nearpod and Canva. But the first thing you're going to have to do is log into your Canva account and actually create the presentation slide that you would like to then upload into your Nearpod presentation. I'll go ahead and show you an example of a presentation slide and activity that I created on Canva so you can get a better idea of how it's going to look. So, as you can see here, I've logged into my Canva account, and this is an activity sheet that I created for my students to use. I have two options for how I can facilitate this in the classroom. Option one, I can save this as a PDF file and I can send it as an attachment to my students to then print out and bring with them to class with them. The second option that I have is to download this as a PNG or JPEG file. I can then upload this onto Nearpod and convert it as a draw it screen so that my students are actually able to complete the activity directly on the presentation slide. So I'm going to show you how to go about and do option two. So you can see that I designed this activity on page 17 of my Canva presentation. What I will do next is I'm going to download this as a JPEG or a PNG file. I can easily do that by going up to the upper right hand corner and hitting download. And I'm gonna just move my head down here so that you can actually see the download button on your screen. So I'm going to click download button, and up at the top, right under the word download, you can see the file type. So I can choose how I would like to save this. I usually prefer to save my images in PNG because it tends to be a higher quality, larger image, whereas the JPEG is a small file size image, but you can choose which one works best for you. You'll click the file type that you would like, and then you have to choose which pages you would like to download. You can see I currently have all 88 pages of this presentation selected. I do not want to download 88 pages. So I'm going to go to page 17, which is the activity that I would like to save. I'm going to click the checkbox, which will turn it purple and let me know that that page has been selected. I'll click the rectangular done button underneath that and give it a second look, make sure everything looks okay, and then click download. The download button is down at the bottom and is purple. It will take a moment for your page to download, but once it does, it's going to pop up saying you saved your design, and then a larger file size of the image will pop up on your screen. So that is now saved in your documents. So all that's left now is to log onto your Nearpod presentation and upload this file image. So what I'm going to do is go to the top of my screen, and I'm going to go into my Nearpod account. I'll type in nearpod.com and wait for it to load. For this example, I'm going to just create a whole brand new presentation to show you. So what I would do once I log into my Nearpod account is I'm going to click the rectangular create button. I'll click the little down arrow, and I want to create a lesson. This will then bring me to a blank lesson where I can then upload any slides that I would choose. So we're going to name this lesson zoo lesson. And I can either click add content and activities, or I can go down here and click upload files. I'm going to click down here and go to upload files. So this is the way that you could download anything that you've created on Canva or created on another platform to then integrate it with Nearpod. From here, I'm going to click this select local file. This will allow me to upload any files that have been saved onto my computer. And then I'm going to have to find it in my documents. So the easiest way for me to do this is go to recents. And then it was titled Summer Ongoing Spanish. I can click on it, make sure that that's the one that I actually would like to upload. And then I'm going to click open. And here you can see it has been successfully added to my PowerPoint. So the reason why I created this slide is because I wanted it to be an activity that my students could draw directly on the screen. So Nearpod has this really cool function called Draw It, and it's very easy to pretty much make any slide that you upload to your Nearpod presentation have that ability to have a student draw on it. So what I will do is I will click on the slide that I want to convert to a Draw It, and up here you'll see that there's an option. There's a blue button that says Convert to Draw It with a little pencil on it. I'll click that, and it's going to ask me, you are able to create a Draw It from this slide. Do you want to keep a copy of the original slide? I usually choose no, because if you click yes, then it's going to have two slides, one that's not interactive and then one that is interactive. I don't really like having the duplicates, and it just makes my presentation way longer than it needs to be, so I usually choose to click no. And as you can see, it's now labeled as a Draw It activity. This means when I go to present it with my students, they are going to be able to draw on their screen and complete the activity that way. At this point, you might be interested in previewing your presentation in order to make sure that everything looks the way you would like to. It's very easy to do this. You just go down to the bottom right-hand-ish corner. It's kind of in the center a little bit, and we're going to click preview. And you can see up at the top that this is a student preview. They've labeled it student preview. This means that this is what your student is going to see when you go to present this live with them. So you can see the presentation slide is very clear. Students can go down to the bottom and click on a colored pen, and then they would be able to complete the activity. So my students would be able to draw on the screen just as I am drawing right now, and then they'd be able to submit that to me, the teacher, so that I can see their progress. So it's great that you're able to kind of get the student preview. This gives you a taste of what your student is going to be seeing, and it also gives you the opportunity to kind of do some problem solving to kind of figure out, okay, if this is what my student is seeing, what are some problems they might possibly encounter along the way, so that you can anticipate some of these problems and come up with solutions before your lesson even starts. Then when I'm done with this student preview, all I have to do is go up to the top and click the little X that's within that circle, and that'll bring me out of the preview page. Once you are all done and you have uploaded any other files that you would like to add to your presentation, you can just click save and exit. So my friends, that is about it. That is how you can create something on Canva, or you could even create designs on some other type of platform that you enjoy. I personally really love using Canva because they have lots of different options for teachers to use in terms of photos and images and elements and things like that. But you can easily upload different images and creations to your Nearpod presentations, either to have them just be a stagnant slide that your student would view, or you can easily make them interactive by clicking that Convert to Draw It feature. So when you are designing your lesson slides, you want to make sure that you're catching and maintaining your students' attention with fun images. Canva allows you to easily do this, which is why I choose to use Canva, even though you could use some other different platforms as well. By then uploading the presentation slides and designs to Nearpod, you can then add interactive features like that Convert to Draw It feature, which is only going to further elevate your lesson. And there you have it, folks. If you have any other questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments section below. Be sure to hit that like and subscribe button if you found this video helpful. And of course, as you continue creating your lessons and find yourself maybe feeling a little overwhelmed or anxious by all the different tools and options that are available to you, please feel free to check out my website and ongoing self-paced workshops. There's lots of free resources on the blog, as well as different PDFs and things that you can have access to that are going to help you through the process. And you can also feel free to reach out to me via Instagram and we can chat that way if you still have questions. So thanks again for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye for now.